Do you ever wish you could go back to the 90s? Life was good back then. Instead of the debt ceiling rising, it was stock prices. With home sales and refinancing in full swing, your toughest decision might have been whether to redo the kitchen or take a vacation. Yup, life was peachy as that tech bubble kept growing bigger and bigger and bigger. But, as bubbles tend to do, it popped. Interest rates flatlined, and the bull market came to a bitter end. The Great Recession hit, impacting all asset classes. In two decades, we watched the market go from incredible growth to unthinkable volatility. Triple-digit market swings are hardly a surprise. And the word on Wall Street is that volatility risk might be here to stay. With this new reality, maybe we should be taking a different approach to investing. But what is that approach? Well, fortunately, while all of this has been going on, Jackson came up with a strategic plan to help you stay invested. They believe there may be a way to help address the uncertainty of the market, and it starts with alternative strategies. I know, the last thing you want to do is think about a new investment plan. But can we really succeed in this new economy by doing things the old way? In the good old days, buying and holding may have delivered returns over the long term. You know, the good old set it and forget it plan. I don't know about you, but I can't just forget it anymore. My point is, we need a strategy that looks for opportunity in volatile markets and tries to deliver returns so you can actually retire someday. What's a way to help do that? Well, maybe it's time to rethink diversification. If I asked you, are your investments diversified like in a traditional 60-40 sense, you might say, sure, I've got my money in bonds and all kinds of stocks. That's diversified, right? Not in today's market, my friend. When things are as volatile as they are now, traditional assets tend to move together, meaning when some of your stocks drop, most of the others do too. Not very helpful, is it? But what if we tried something a little less mainstream? I'm talking about adding alternative assets, or alts for short. These are things like futures, commodities, or arbitrage strategies. Often, alternative assets like these move opposite from traditional assets. Of course, past performance is no guarantee of future results. Now, you seem like a pretty nice person, so I'll let you in on a little secret. Private institutions and Ivy League schools have been investing in alts for decades, combining them with traditional investments to achieve higher returns with lower risk. Take a look. In the 10-year period, endowments with assets over $1 billion that invested 60% in alternatives saw an average return of 5%, while the S&P 500 returned a loss of 1.6% in the same period. Who's the smarty pants now? And I'm not just saying that because I graduated from Yale. Now, while these investments aren't exactly the same as what private institutions and Ivy League schools use, they do seek a similar result. In the past, it was hard for most investors to gain access to alternatives due to high minimum investments and restrictive requirements. But now, elite access makes them available to you. As long as we're on a roll, let me give you another little tidbit of information. By adding alts to your portfolio, you may help improve your diversification, reduce risk, and potentially increase your returns. Now, why do we think this? Well, some brainy folks conducted a study from 2001 to 2010. It compared three portfolios. One was a mix of just stocks, bonds, and cash, while the others added alts to the mix. Now, before I show you the effects alts had on these portfolios, let me test you with a term you may not have heard since stat class, standard deviation. Anyone remember what that means? Anyone? Anyone? Okay, well, let me just remind you that standard deviation is known as historical volatility, and it's used to gauge the amount of expected volatility or risk. All that really means is that the lower the standard deviation percentage, the lower the risk. Now, back to the portfolios. The one with no alts had a return of 4.85% and a standard deviation, aka risk, of 11.03%, while the portfolio with 20% alts had a return of 5.41% and a standard deviation of just 7.73%. And the portfolio with 30% alts had a return of 5.78% and a standard deviation of, wait for it, just 6.49%. So you can see that adding alts to the portfolio decreased risk and increased returns. Bada bing. In addition to investing in alts, you might need some strategies to help you maneuver in uncertain markets, which brings us to the second component of Elite Access, risk management. These strategies seek to manage risk on a daily basis by using a series of sophisticated formulas. Here's how it works in human speak. You have two complementary portfolios, a higher risk portfolio made of traditional and alternative assets, and a very low risk portfolio made of short-term conservative investments. The money managers then use the risk of the market to define the portfolio's allocation. When the market trends downward, the money is moved out of the market to try and get out of that risky situation. As things improve, the money goes back into the market. Simple and pretty savvy. So risk management seeks to address risk on a day-to-day basis. Then we have tactical management, which responds to the market on a monthly basis. These strategies combine formulas with research and decision-making to create a more holistic picture of the market. Depending on the analysis, asset classes are overweighted or underweighted to help capture gains over time. The money managers closely monitor market patterns so they can respond to market cycles, positive and negative. Now, some of you might be thinking, that all sounds great, but do I have to build a new portfolio on my own? As feelings of dread promptly ensue? The answer is only if you want to. You can customize your own investments or choose a managed portfolio that's crafted for specific investment goals. Pretty cool, huh? Before you go, there's one more thing you'll want to hear. With Elite Access, your investments grow tax deferred, so you get to keep more of your money invested, which can make a really big difference in the long run. Plus, you get the added benefit of tax efficiency. Elite Access is one of the few options that provides tactical portfolio management so you can avoid all the tax forms that are ordinarily created by frequent trading. You can choose investments and adjust allocations without all those pesky papers to deal with at the end of the year. Because, let's face it, life isn't about paperwork. It's all about the Benjamins, baby. Oh, did we cut that part from the script? Sorry. So, in a metaphorical nutshell, Elite Access is designed to help you manage risk and help you stay invested. And while alternative investments, risk management, tactical strategies, and tax deferral may be available in other products at a variety of costs, Elite Access offers the ability to combine these features into one neat package. I hope I've helped paint a picture of why Elite Access provides a new way to go beyond traditional investing. So, why wait? Talk to your representative about how Elite Access can work for you and tell them Ben sent you. Thank you.